Yeah, 1954. The monkeys went to war. They lost their guns and used their bums in 1954. It's a kindergarten joke. Yeah, everyone's doing it, picking their nose and chewing it. Everybody's doing it, picking their bum and chewing it. Okay, this is a lengthy synopsis. No, it's going to be a brief synopsis. I'm 55, I'll be 56 in May. I live in Preston, Fleabag Hotel, Bedbug Hotel. I walk up and down King Street with my sign, right, which states, homeless man requires $1. Sometimes I confuse him by saying homeless man requires $2, right? I'm like the Florida man who lost his job at the orange juice factory. He couldn't concentrate, right? Attention deficit disorder. That's what I've got, right? Attention deficit syndrome. It's a winter condition, right? It's brought about by lack of sunlight, right? Like, that's my psychiatrist, right? I'm under the care of a psychiatrist right now, right? Did I tell you? And he said, well, I should go to Hawaii, right, to cure my condition. But the problem is, how am I supposed to push a shopping cart, like, you know, down a 401, right, to Vancouver, and then get on an airplane, right, to go to Hawaii, right, to restore my equilibrium. Gotta go to Bermuda, go the other way. Or just watch a movie about Africa. If you go to Florida, like, you know, a place like Key West, Florida, I was there one time, right? I drove down there years ago. I needed a part for my car. So I went to the auto records, right? And you see all these cars that were just abandoned, right, by students, right? You know, you look at the plates, right? Texas, Maryland, you know, like Pennsylvania, right? Virginia, right? New York, right? Like brand new cars, right? Just abandoned, right? Students would just leave them there, right? And fly back or walk back or hitchhike back, and their parents would buy up a new car, right? Meantime, the guy with the tow truck, you know, in Florida, Key West, Florida, right? He'd just drive around and collect all these brand new cars and, you know, get them off the streets, right? Sell the parts. I couldn't believe it, right? See? Rich society, right? If you live in Afghanistan or Russia, right, they'd be a guard with an AK-47 guarding all these auto parts, right? See, because it's very lucrative here. This town of Waterloo, right, they have two colleges, right? And the students, yeah, in April, they leave town. They leave their textbooks, right? They leave, you know, all that merchandise, all those appliances, right? Like, you know, so the landlord comes in and throws everything out, right? So you walk by, you see a nice TV, right? For example, right? Or you see microwave, right? Or you see refrigerator, right? Or something, right? Something of value, right? A lot of books and stuff, right? And you see, especially, like, empty beer bottles and empty beer cans, right? Like, you know, cultural detritus, whatever, right? So what I do, I zero in on that, right? I focus on the beer cans and the beer bottles, right? And then if you get a beer can, what you do, you stomp on it, right? Like, you crush it, right? Then you get more into your shopping cart, right? That's how they do it in Alberta, right? Like, and then I make a sign. Once in a while, I make a sign, like, we'll accept your empty beer cans, empty beer bottles, right? One time, I had this sign on the side of my shopping cart in Fort McMurray, Alberta, back in 2003. In one day, I made, like, $92, right? That was a good score, right? $92 in one day, right? Using the sign, right? See, advertising, right? Sign psychology, right? See? There's money to be made in garbage, right? Well, if I wasn't making money, I wouldn't be doing it, right? But then you have your good days, you have your bad days, right? The average is up, right? The art of begging, right? Yeah, I feel like that guy, Robinson Crusoe. Eventually, you meet your fellow mankind, right? And then, if your fellow mankind, if he's in a good mood, right, he'll help you out, you know, give you a couple bucks, right? But then you see your fellow mankind, like, he could be a little bit brutal. He'll use the F word, right, and say, hey, go get a job, right? And then you feel like running away, right, for a while, right? But then you get over it, right? But then if you go to the barn, right, by yourself, then you feel really lonely, right? You sort of wish you had a horse with you, or like an animal, like a dog or a horse, right?
You do, because you hurt yourself when you're there.
In the barn.
You by yourself, you talk to yourself 24/7.
I do? Or you do?
Everybody does.
Yeah, I guess people do, yeah. So like an astronaut, you're like you're way up there, right?
Wind in the canyon, moon on the rise. As long as we can sail away. As long as we can sail away, there'll be wind in the canyon.